Hello everyone, my name is Rohit and welcome to my channel. In this video, I will show you how to build an AI chatbot using Next.js and OpenAI API. We will use Tailwind CSS to style our chatbot a bit. If you face any issues, then feel free to comment here or DM me on my social media handles, whatever you prefer. The links are in the description. So without any further delay, let's get started. So I started a Next.js app with the project name Chatbot. These are my default settings for this project. Next, navigate to the Chatbot directory and install the OpenAI package using the command npm install OpenAI. Next, open this project in your favorite code editor and open the page.js file inside the app directory. We won't be modifying the default code at this time. Simply run the project using the command npm run dev. Change the default theme from dark to light. To create a chatbot using the OpenAI API, in the next tab, search for OpenAI and click on openai.com. If you don't have an account, create one. I already have an account. Once you are logged in, you will see this interface. Click on API. Click on API keys and then click on create new secret key. Name your key and click on create. Don't share this key with anyone. We will use this key in our project. Copy it and head back to the project root directory. Inside the project root directory, create a file named .env.local. Add your OpenAI API key to this file. Now go back to the page.js file and delete the default code before writing the code for the chatbot. We start by importing the necessary libraries. In this case, we import React and useState from React and OpenAI for our AI-powered chatbot. We create a new instance of OpenAI, passing an object with two properties, API key and dangerously allow browser. The dangerously allow browser property is set to true, which means we are allowing the browser to make a request to the OpenAI API directly. This is not recommended for production, as it exposes our secret key to the public. We should use the server-side proxy instead, but for the sake of simplicity, we will use this option for now. Inside the home component, we use the useState hook to create three state variables, user input, chat history, and is loading. The user input state holds the value of the input field where the user can type their questions. The chat history state holds an array of objects, each representing a message in the chat. Each message has a role property, which can be either user or assistant, and a content property, which is the text of the message. The isLoading state is a boolean that indicates whether the chatbot is loading a response or not. Perfect. Next, we define a function called handleUserInput, which will be called when the user clicks the ask button. It sets the isLoading state to true, which will show a loading indicator on the button. It updates the chat history state, adding a new message object with the role of user and the content of the user input state. Next, we call the OpenAI chat completion API, passing an object with two properties, messages and model. The messages property is an array of messages object which represents the chat history so far. We added one more message object with the role of assistant and the content of the user input state to simulate what the assistant would say. The model property is the name of the OpenAI model that we want to use to generate the chatbot response. We use GPT 3.5 Turbo, which is a faster and powerful model that can handle a variety of tasks. You can use any model of your choice if you have a paid account. Next, we update the chat history state again, adding a new message object with the role of assistant and the content of the chat completion.choices bracket 0.message.content. This is the response that the OpenAI model generated based on the chat history and the user input. The chat completion object has a choices property, which is an array of possible responses. We pick the first one, which is usually the most relevant one. At last, we set the user input state to an empty string and set the isLoading state to false. Next, we return some JSX that renders the chatbot interface. We use a div element with some classes to style the background and the layout of the page. We use a Tailwind CSS framework which provides a set of utility classes that we can use to quickly style our elements. The first part is a div element with some classes to style the header of the chatbot. Inside this div element, we have a div element with some classes to style the title of the chatbot, which is a chatbot assistant. We also have a paragraph element with some classes to style the subtitle of the chatbot, which is "Welcome to the future of AI-powered assistant, ask me anything." The second part is a div element with some classes to style the chat area of the chatbot. We also give this div element a style attribute which sets the height and the overflow property. The height property sets the height of the chat area to 400 pixels and the overflow property sets the scroll behavior to auto, which means it will show a scroll bar when the content exceeds the height. Inside this div element, we use the map method to iterate over the chat history state. And for each message object, we render a div element with some classes to style the message. We use a conditional expression to check the role property of the message, and depending on whether it is user or assistant, we style the message differently. We also use a template literal to insert the first letter of the role into the message bubble to indicate who is speaking. We also use a key attribute to give each message a unique identifier, which helps React to optimize the rendering performance. The third part is a div element with some classes to style the input area of the chatbot. Inside this div element, we have an input element and a button element. The input element has a type attribute of text, which means it is a text field. It also has a placeholder attribute, which shows some text when the input is empty. It also has a value attribute, which binds the input value to the user input state. It also has an onChange attribute, which sets the user input state to the event.target.value, which is the current value of the input. The button element has an onClick attribute, which calls the handleUserInput function, which we defined earlier. It also has some classes to style the button and a conditional expression to show either ask or loading depending on the isLoading state. Now we are all set, it's time to test our application. The response of the AI bot might be slow depending on the server load, however it feels so cool to build an AI chatbot. The chatbot looks pretty decent. If you want to show me your version of the chatbot, you can work on the UI on your own. You can use my social media to reach out to me. Listen, if you received an error with a status code of 429, it might be possible that you exceeded the time limit for using your API key. I understand that you never used your API key. However, OpenAI counts this time frame from the time you created your OpenAI account and started using ChatGPT. But don't worry, there are two methods to solve this. First, you can set up your paid account and they will renew your access. Second, you can create a new account with a new Gmail address and a new phone number. Remember that using a new phone number is important. Don't use your old phone number or you will encounter the same issue. That's it for this video. If you found this video helpful, then give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more Next.js tutorials. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next one.